Hi, this is Dr. Peter Kahn. I'm the creator of Neurometabolic Integration line of professional supplements. Now in this video, I'm going to talk about Acetyl Glutathione Pro. Now glutathione is a master antioxidant. Every single cell in your body produces glutathione because by virtue of breathing oxygen for energy, we create what's called oxidative stress. And this is one of the main reasons why we age through this oxidative damage. Glutathione is one of the main intracellular antioxidants that help protect against oxidative stress. So it's really important for cellular function as an antioxidant. It also protects the mitochondria. Your mitochondria, which is a cellular machinery that produces ATP, produces energy, is very sensitive to inflammatory and oxidative damage. And glutathione protects the mitochondria against that oxidative damage. It also supports the T regulatory cell function. In those with autoimmune disease, such as Hashimoto's, MS, lupus, rheumatoid arthritis, glutathione is the key antioxidant that helps balance your T regulatory cells. It's actually a nutrient used by the T regulatory cells to optimize its own function, therefore decreasing this autoimmune reactivity. Glutathione is also used to balance that Th1, Th2 activity. So in autoimmune disease, your immune system becomes skewed on one side over the other. The glutathione help you balance that. Glutathione also help protect the gut barrier. If you have leaky gut, glutathione is really important to protect the gut and also protect the blood-brain barrier as well. Glutathione also help with heavy metal detox. It's actually one of the phase 2 liver detox pathway called glutathione conjugation. And glutathione has a high affinity for mercury and lead, so it's very important for it in a detoxification process. Now, there are many different evolutions or forms of glutathione. It started out with oral glutathione in a powder form. They are called reduced glutathione. Now, the problem with that is studies have shown that reduced glutathione in an oral form is not well absorbed. They done a study where they have people ingest high amounts of glutathione and you do blood tests to measure how much glutathione is in the body, and they showed that the amount didn't really go up, indicating poor oral absorption. So we had to come up with other ways of getting glutathione in the system. And these other ways includes IV glutathione. So you can get glutathione in the IV, you can inject it, but you know, it's kind of pain and you have to go get it done and it's hard to just do it on yourself every day. And then they come up with glutathione nebulized, which we used to do with our clients. So you can take glutathione, reduce glutathione, put it in a nebulizer and you can breathe it in. It's absorbed through the lung into your bloodstream. That can work as well. However, glutathione is a sulfur-containing compound, so it makes your house smells like sulfur. So it's got this rotten egg smell to it. And you gotta, you know, use the machine. It's kind of pain in the butt as well, so compliance wasn't great. And then you also have suppository glutathione, who likes to stick something up their butt, right? So compliance kind of sucked there as well. And then, so they came out with what's called a liposomal glutathione in a liposomal cream, topical. So then you can rub it into your skin. The idea is that if you rub it into your skin, it's absorbed into your skin, and that kind of bypasses the GI tract so that you're not having that absorption issue. Although that can be absorbed that way, however, the absorption rate depends on the individual. Some people, you know, have less body fat, more body fat, depends on your genetics, and the absorption rate is just very hard to control by rubbing into your skin. It can be great for topical treatment. You can rub glutathione into your skin for any kind of inflammation problems. You can even rub it into the thyroid for those with Hashimoto. That can actually reduce inflammation in the thyroid gland. But again, it's a more of a topical type of application. So the search for an oral form continues, and then we have liposomal glutathione in a liquid form where you can actually take this liquid, and in a liposomal form, the glutathione is encased in little liposome spheres. So it's like little fat spheres. So that protects the glutathione until it's absorbed through the GI tract so that you can get it into your system. That seemed to work really well, and we actually carry the Seeking Health Optimal Liposomal Glutathione form on our neurometabolicsupplements.com site. Then we came up with the acetylglutathione. S-acetylglutathione is a different form of glutathione to reduced glutathione, which is what you're getting in all these other forms. The S-acetyl form turns out is very well orally tolerated. In fact, studies have shown that S-acetylglutathione absorbed very well. In fact, just as well as increasing glutathione level as IV glutathione. So this eliminates the need to inject and things like that. So if you are having autoimmune issue, you have inflammation, you have Hashimoto's, you're looking for supporting the heavy metal detox pathway, then S-acetylglutathione is what you want to be using. Typical dose is 2 caps once a day. For specific applications, we may go higher, 2 cap twice a day, even 2 cap 3 times a day in specific situations. Glutathione, again, is an intracellular antioxidant. So your body naturally produces it, and there's no toxicity associated with it. In fact, it can only help with toxicity. So it's very safe, it's well tolerated. It's basically just one of the things like water. You know, you can't really react to water. And it's for most people, this tolerates really well. So hope this helps you, and we'll see you on your next video. Thank you.